is Norwich back to watch more.
Hunter! Hunter!
Oh, we brought the classic back.
Why are you episode 64. This one's called Strengthen and Threaten.
Strengthen and Threaten.
What?
It seems like he was trying to make it rhyme there, but he was like, Strengthen and Threaten.
A hard tutor, strengthen and threaten.
A hard master.
Oh, God.
Damn it.
I like biscuit. I like biscuits.
Can I have a sip of your water?
Biscuit.
I like biscuits from Cleaner.
Can I have 3 sips total?
Yes.
Biscuit gulps.
Man, my left ear is done, dudes.
Biscuit chat.
Your left nut is
my left ear, man. Rana screamed in my left ear. It's not her fault, but she's done it the last 2 times.
For like every show.
Breaking Bad, it was a big one. I mean, I don't blame her. Right now, it hurts.
I hear people complaining about your screams in Breaking Bad.
I think you need to start one of those eargasms just 24/7.
I'm just like, okay, that's like the only hate that Rana's ever gotten.
What?
Cool. That she screams sometimes loudly in Breaking Bad. Like we get hate all on the regular, so I'm glad Rana has like one thing to humble her.
I'm not gonna say anything
about that. Alrighty, y'all. So we are continuing on with this story. The last episode was pretty dope, man. It was a big training session. I felt really bad. We shouldn't have felt bad for, because he was a killer, but...
When they showed his backstory, that was kind of fucked up what happened to him.
Benolt.
Hey, man, we are all... Man, what is it that Mewtwo says? Is it we're all circumstances. In this life,
it's a good quote.
It's a good quote.
Talking about the Pokemon movie?
Yeah, Mewtwo is a really good quote. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, Mewtwo... prophetic, bro.
Oh, man, I'm gonna look it up.
I remember the Mewtwo movie. That show was amazing. You guys remember the Mewtwo movie?
Yeah. Where, Pikachu's tears revive Ash or some shit? Or Mew's tears?
I remember the art cover to that movie.
Yeah, like Mew over there.
Do you remember the Togepi movie?
Wow, we have severely gotten off track. I don't know how we start talking about
that.
I never noticed until, like, we're way weird.
This is a quote. I see now that the circumstances of one's birth are irrelevant. It is what you do with the gift of life that determines who you are. So
that was in a movie.
That is an excuse, Benot, my friend.
Unless you get bitch slapped by a rich person for doing a nice thing, and then there happens to be a half a scissor laying next to you, then clearly.
And then you just shake him in the neck, and then from then on, you become a killer.
Clearly.
And then you don't realize your midlife crisis until 2 young boys use you as torturous training in a pit.
In a video game on an island.
Kill
one, God,
learn new.
Cool, we tied it together. Anyway, this isn't a market substitute. Please support the official release on Hulu. You can also support the Normies on Patreon. Doing so, you will get ahead a few episodes. This show gets the most double drops out of all our shows that we do. And, you know, when you support us on Patreon, you help us do podcasts, skits, video games, you know, all that in the description. We have links. Check us out in the Discord. 100 Frame the Discord is pretty awesome. And we're going to start this episode now.
Press play.
Yeah, let's do this.
You gotta live an interesting life.
Okay, I'll press play. They killed what's his face?
Like, it was no one's business, bro. Fucking killed him. And then this bomber guy comes out of nowhere like a dick. He's such a dick. He's just using the whole entire time, bro. He's been like hiding in their midst, being their friends and shit. And
watch out for the bomber.
I'm the bomber. I bombed all of you guys. And I'm going to take all your stuff. Ha ha ha.
That's the key word. They have to say bomber.
At first, I thought he was going to say something. He was like, hey, before we start, I just have something to say. I thought he was going to be like,
Puhat. I think it's Puhat. I don't know.
I thought he was going to serve a big purpose too.
It seemed like
he was going to be the back
this
and forth.
Is 100%
it wasn't enough just to kill the guy.
They had to behead him,
put him in a fucking Kroger bag. He delivered to them
straight shaggy dog shit.
This episode, I think it delved into the next curriculum of Nen. Put that. This is me first. Well. So we got to learn the other curriculum of Nen, which it's Ko.
Keep learning so Ken. Ko, Ken.
Ko. Ratios.
Ryu.
What else? Is there another one I'm missing, I feel like?
Yeah.
No, but to get Ko, you have to like combine what? Tetsu, Ren.
You combine all of them,
basically.
In one spot. And Ken is more just enveloping, shielding your whole body, but it's not as strong as Ko.
No.
Because, you know, you have to spread it out
your
whole body.
Ko, Ryu, and what was the other one?
Ken.
And so that rock, paper, scissors thing, too.
That was really, really cool.
So check that. But the Dragon, I think Dragon Ball used to do that. Like, Goku had the rock, paper, scissors technique. But I always used to get so annoyed because in the manga, I think it would be scissors, rock, paper. And I was like, that's not the order.
Scissors,
but,
rock, paper.
Yeah, it was kind of cool how she made those into actual techniques there. And
paper. Oh no, wait. Rock, scissors, paper.
Yeah, yeah.
She like held it like weirdly for scissors, like you're actually holding a pair of scissors.
Yeah, the scissors was like a some sort of like
yeah
technique to
yeah
you know.
Yeah, that was cool.
Maybe we'll see that in action. Maybe we'll see that in action.
A lot of time is passing by. I mean, for the first part, already a month had passed. At least a month and 2 weeks passed. Plus a month.
Yeah, oh, damn.
Yeah, so like a month and 2 weeks.
Because,
they dug that hole.
Bisky or whatever, man, she's fucking training the fuck out of these boys, bro, making them dig, and now, like, fighting and shit. Like, I think her plan is to, like, before they go to Bastador, to be completely, like, full-stack warriors, man, and, like, get as many cards as they can.
Yeah. It was cool how Gon and Killua were slowly punching, you know, at first, and then they got better at it, and I like how they walked us through it, like, how it's like, all right, 80% offense, 80% defense. It just shows, I do feel like they are getting stronger. Like, it's doing a good job of showing us progression. Like, they're getting I feel like I'm getting stronger with them learning more about it.
They have
shoulders
on their
calculations and everything, man. They're using their brains, too, not just, like, the bodies and everything.
It's ridiculous,
man. Overall.
So much detail. I mean, I can't even imagine when they were like writing this to like spider web all this shit. Like, you know,
I think one person wrote this.
Starting from then and like spread out all the attributes and then those tie into other things. Like, I would love to see the spider web. Like, once we're deep into the series and there's not much more.
If there's like
a web. If there's like a web of like everything that's connected. God. Like, this shit is intricate as fuck, yo.
Yeah, it is.
Phantom Troop found their way. The natural way to
did they leave and then come back the regular way, or were they like I'm a little confused by that.
Wasn't Shalmar looking at the book and shit?
He was summoning the book and all, so maybe
were they on that too, or was it just like the other people who haven't been on that yet?
I think Shalmar, Goth Velma
were already there,
and Cortopi
because
might already be there,
so the rules won't affect them. Maybe like they can use Nen on like some of the monsters. Like, remember how they can't use Nen on certain cards and stuff like that. I don't know. Maybe them being there in the real world will affect the rules of the game somehow, or how they interact with the
because they didn't come into the interface.
Yeah, I mean, it has to, right?
Yeah, because they bypassed the one chick that loads you in there, and she's probably the one that puts the limitations on you.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't think it's on you per se. I think it's on the islands. Like, I think the island's automatically doing responses.
Like, once you just
are you saying the island is like
alive,
sentient?
Yeah, it's the island doing stuff back, not the people, basically.
They're just island. What's the island lost without that
they're just fighting on a large lion turtle.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, that's a sentient island right there.
Yeah.
Me seeing them train and get so good and so fast makes me think what Kurapika and Liori are doing right now.
Yeah, dude, I'm saying, like, if Kurapika knew all this extra shit when he was fighting the troop, it would have been over.
He
still fared pretty damn well. Though.
But I'm saying he would have been like,
I hope Leorio is getting a good enough training.
Well, he's a doctor.
He's gonna be our medic.
Doctor.
He's gonna be our medic.
He'll be good.
He's gonna be our medic.
Anything else we are missing?
No, those are
the
all
boys
the
are
things.
Good. That's all I can say.
Yeah, man, boys are
I hope Gon and Killua come and rescue the sick man in the cave, and they kill the bombers.
Yeah,
straight poop. Why would they
bombers, guys?
Or I hope the Phantom Troop runs into the bombers. It's like, bitch.
That would be a lot funnier.
Why would they put Poo Hot in the intro and then just
I thought he was
gonna press up in the comments for
I can see the Phantom Troop coming in and be like, well, you got all these bombs, and like Phaeton or somebody does something really tricky and just, or Shalmar just, all the bombs are done.
Yeah.
Something crazy. The Phantom Troop is.
Yeah, I can see Shalmar.
I feel like Phantom Troop might be, we might start liking him a lot more. I don't know.
Yeah, they're about to wild card the shit out of this game.
All right, well, guys, I think
see
those are all
side.
The things.
F's in the chat for Pooha.
I said F's.
All right, y'all. See you guys soon.